this After Effects tutorial, I'll show you how to animate this explosion transition. Hi guys, my name is Manuel. We'll animate the main shape frame by frame, then add more details. Alright, let's get started. As always, we need a new comp. Name it Explosion, 1920 by 1080 pixels, 2 seconds long. Then we create the main shape the animation is based on. We choose the polygon tool, double click on it, white fill, no stroke. We name the new shape Explosion as well. Then we select the polystar path, right click on it and convert it into a Bezier path. We select the path, choose the convert vertex tool and curve the straight edges inwards. We click on the points and split the handles, drag them to the center to create a typical graphic explosion frame. Finally, let's move some of the points to make the shape look more random. So that's obviously not the beginning of the explosion. We move the start point to 2 frames and set a path keyframe at 8. Right click on it and make it a toggle hold keyframe. We move to 10 frames and move the points further outwards. To make that easier, we add CC white time. Set forward and backward steps to 2. Disable the fill and set the stroke width to 10. So when we move the points, we still can see the previous shape, which is awesome. We move all the points further out. Adjust the curves. At 12 frames, the shape covers the whole screen. Then let's add the beginning. We move to 6 frames, select the path and scale it down. We see 2 shapes because there's a frame in between. We turn the keyframe into a toggle hold keyframe and adjust the form a little bit. At 4 frames, we scale it down some more. Toggle hold keyframe. Toggle hold keyframes prevent any animation until the next keyframe, by the way. We adjust the shape. At 2 frames, it's very small. Again, we turn it into a toggle hold keyframe. Let's move it to the center. We add the fill again, delete the stroke and deactivate CC white time. We basically reduce the frame rate to 12 frames by using toggle hold keyframes. Awesome! Next we add a solid, color black, and name it ball action. Of course, we add CC ball action. Set grid spacing to around 10, ball size to around 30. Let's go further back to actually see what we just did. We move the start point of the solid to 4 frames. Then duplicate the explosion layer, move it above the new solid, to 4 frames, and use it as Luma track mat. If you can't see this, you have to click the button down here. It looks like there's too much white space here, so let's scale up the explosion layer and adjust the shape a little bit. We quickly go through all the frames. Awesome. We add another solid, name it Noise, and move the start point to 6 frames. This time we add Turbulent Noise. Fractal type, basic, noise type, block, contrast, 1500, brightness, 150. In transform, we deselect uniform scaling and set scale width to 6000, scale height to 10, complexity 1. Then we add CC Collider. Collider, mirroring, stylish, size around 115, rotation around 100 degrees, so that it looks like a star. Then we duplicate the explosion 2 layer and move it above the beginning to 6 frames. Use it as Luma Mat again. Awesome, That looks really cool. We duplicate the bottom explosion layer once more, move it to the top of the layer stacking order, and the start point to 8 frames. Awesome. We duplicate the explosion 4 layer, move it back 2 more frames, and name it explosion out. And set the mode to silhouette alpha, which makes all the layers below it transparent. Within the shape, let's quickly add a background solid, which makes it easier to see. Alright. Finally, we add some speed lines. With no layer selected, we grab the pen tool. We use the title and action save for some orientation and draw a line from right of the center to beyond the right edge. Let's name the layer speed line. We set the stroke width to 30 pixels. We go into the stroke property and in taper, we set the start length to 100%. Let's close all this stuff again. And let's add trim paths. We open the trim paths property and set the start and end to 0. We set an end keyframe at the beginning, a start keyframe at 2 frames. We set end to 100% at 4 frames, and start to 100% at 8 frames. And we set the endpoint to 9 frames. And add post-rest time and set the frame rate to 12. To match the frame rate of the other animations. To change the direction of the line, we simply rotate it. We duplicate the line a few times, at the beginning, just before the main explosion. And then some more at the end. Like they're dragging after the main explosion. That's it. Check out the links in the description. On the left side, I've added some videos you might like. Subscribe to my channel on the right side and hit the bell, because you don't want to miss my next video. Thanks for watching this one. See you in the next one. Bye, guys.